The routine is the same 7 days a week. Gonzalo Amaya gets up at sunrise and herds his cows to the milking station. The little dairy farm in the central Andean region of Colombia produces 170 liters of milk a day. Gonzalo is part of a farmers' cooperative and even owns a diesel-powered milking machine for his 14 cows. The fresh milk is immediately being picked up by the cooperative's truck, and time is of the essence. The important thing is that the milk is cooled as quickly as possible. So when the roads are good, it is much easier. When milk is not transported quickly, it acidifies, and that costs us because it lowers the price of the milk. It's necessary that the roads are in good shape so that the milk is not spoiled and we can make a good profit. And that is easier said than done. Colombia suffers from a poor infrastructure, roads are in bad shape or don't even exist. And years of armed conflict have added to the neglect. A huge burden for businesses across all sectors. Nobody knows that better than Alqueria, Colombia's largest milk processing company. 1.2 million liters of milk are processed here every day. 60% of the milk is bought from small farmers across the country. In this post-conflict society, this means a lot of jobs for Colombians in every region of the country. Alqueria's CEO is eager to win even more small farms as suppliers and is promoting milk farming instead of coca farming, so farmers can rely on legal sources of income. But one of the biggest obstacles to enlist small farmers from remote parts of the country are roads that provide for a speedy transport.
Our trucks travel 30,000 kilometers a day from our collection centers to the farms and back. If the bad roads turn into good roads, we could have possibly a 50% increase in the productivity of those 100 trucks.
Colombia's government is eager to boost the economy. 8,000 kilometers of new roads shall be built, the price tag $25 billion. A financial task too monumental for local banks alone.
The 32 projects that we are supporting, they were financed 48% through local banks and the other 52% using capital markets, using international banks, using multilaterals, and FDN being one of the sources. But we, more than a direct lender, we were a catalyzer.
Connecting institutional investors such as pension funds with large infrastructure projects and regulatory reform has changed Colombia's ability to tackle peacetime challenges. An initiative helped by the International Finance Corporation, effectively creating a market for infrastructure financing and saving billions in public debt. Should you ever enjoy Colombian milk collected from Gonzalo and other cooperative members, remember, a lot of international and local actors mobilized funds to help these farmers thrive. This concept is a first for Colombia, and certainly not the last time it will be applied in Latin America and around the world.